stand for the bride. You usually stand for the bride, not for the... You don't stand for... Stand. You stand for the bride, not...
Makes me stronger than you. we may proceed. May the Father give the bride. So we are gathered here together. To celebrate the holy union between Sergio and Crystal, but first I'm going to ask you to remain your feet while we go in prayer before our God to ask him for his presence and his guidance through the holy ceremony. Dear Lord, we come to you in Jesus' name. Thank you for this amazing moment. For the beginning of this family, for everything that is going to take part today. We ask you to take control of everything and to give us all an amazing experience of your presence. We ask in Jesus' name, amen.
Te amé, te deseo, ven camina junto a mí, tú me puedes entender. Quiero llevar tu olor en mi espíritu, inundarme de ti, quiero estar en ti, que me guíes en mi caminar, gracias por estar aquí, por estar en mí, sosteniéndome, ayudándome, consolando.
You can take your seats. I have been asked for the groom to ask you to not use your cell phone during the ceremony because they don't want to take a picture of you taking a picture. So they have their own people taking photographs and later on we can have them. Okay? Thank you.
Por favor, que no tomen fotos durante la ceremonia, ya que hay un equipo que va a estar en cargo de eso.
Okay, as I was telling you before, we are here to celebrate marriage.
Estamos acá para celebrar matrimonio.
But what is marriage?
Pero ¿qué es matrimonio?
The first thing that you have to remember is that marriage is not a contract.
Lo primero que tienen que entender el matrimonio es que no es un contrato.
But a covenant.
Un pacto.
Because a contract can be broken.
Porque un contrato puede ser roto.
But a covenant will remain until one of you dies or Jesus returns.
Pero un pacto dura hasta que uno de ustedes muera o Jesús vuelva.
The holy matrimony was established by God.
El santo matrimonio fue establecido por Dios.
Not by men.
No por hombres.
As many may think.
Como muchos piensan.
For that reason.
Por esa razón.
It is only God.
Es solo Dios.
The one who can define it.
El único que puede definirlo.
And he actually does it.
Y de hecho lo hace.
We find it in Genesis chapter 2, verse 24.
Encontramos en Génesis capítulo 2, versículo 24.
That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife. Es por eso que el hombre deja a su padre y a su madre y se une a su mujer, and they become one flesh.
Se convierten en uno solo.
Marriage is between one man and one woman.
Matrimonio es entre un hombre y una mujer.
Everything that is outside this design is not marriage.
Todo lo que está fuera de este diseño no es matrimonio.
Not as God created it.
No como Dios lo creó.
And for that reason, it cannot produce what God has planned.
Y por esa razón no puede producir lo que Dios ha planeado.
And what He has promised.
Y lo que ha prometido.
As we just read in the Bible.
Como ven en la Biblia.
The moment that you marry each other.
El momento en que se casan.
You are leaving father and mother.
Están viviendo padre, dejando padre y madre.
And becoming one.
Y convirtiéndose en uno.
But what does it mean leaving father and mother?
Pero ¿qué significa dejar a su padre y a su madre?
It means that you are becoming a new family.
Significa que se están convirtiendo en una nueva familia.
Starting this moment.
Desde este momento.
When you speak about your family.
Cuando hablan de su familia.
You have to speak about each other.
Tienen que hablar de uno de los.
Because you are starting one family.
Están empezando una nueva familia.
And it's very important that you understand that really soon, right now.
Y es muy importante que entiendan eso ahora mismo.
Because many of the people in sad marriage.
Porque muchos de los que están en matrimonio.
Is that one or the two don't understand this part and they want to bring their old family into this new family.
Que no entienden esta parte y quieren traer su antigua familia a esta familia.
So it is important to understand that now each of you is priority to each other.
Es importante que entiendan que ahora tienen que tener prioridad uno del otro.
You are leaving father and mother.
Están dejando a padre y a madre.
And you are becoming a new family.
Y se están convirtiendo en una nueva familia.
Where you, Sergio, are going to be father.
Donde tú, Sergio, vas a ser el padre.
And Crystal, you are the mother.
Y Crystal, vas a ser la madre.
You are still going to honor your parents, of course.
Todavía van a honrar a sus padres, por supuesto.
If you want to have a long life with a lot of blessings, you do it.
Si quieren tener una vida larga con muchas bendiciones, lo harán.
But you have to understand that you are starting a new family.
Pero tienen que entender que están empezando una nueva familia.
But I want to focus in the part where it says that you are becoming one.
Pero quiero enfocarme en la parte que dice que se convierten en uno.
And it is a beauty in there.
Hay una belleza en eso.
When God created Adam.
Cuando Dios creó a Adán.
The Bible says that God created mankind.
La Biblia dice que Dios creó la humanidad.
And actually says that He created them male and female.
Y de hecho dice que los creó hombre y mujer.
But as we see, in that moment, He had only created Adam.
Pero como en ese momento solo había creado a Adán.
But the word said that He created male and female.
Pero la palabra dice que creó a hombre y a mujer.
So you have to understand.
Tienen que entender.
That in that moment.
Que en ese momento.
Eve was already created.
Ya fue creada.
Only she was present in Adam as one.
Solo que estaba presente en Adán como uno.
What happened after that is that God actually separated them.
Lo que pasó después de eso es que Dios los separó.
Well, marriage is the moment.
Matrimonio es el momento.
When He joins them back together.
Cuando los une de vuelta.
To become one.
Para convertirse en uno.
To become a whole one.
Para convertirse en un uno entero.
You are no longer two.
Ya no son más dos.
But one.
Sino uno.
A whole new one.
Un nuevo
a
uno.
A stronger one.
Uno más fuerte.
A complete one.
Uno más completo.
And it happens by the strength of a covenant.
Y empieza con el fortalecimiento del pacto.
It is what Sergio and Crystal are doing today.
Es lo que Sergio y Crystal están haciendo.
Your vows.
Sus votos.
Are a covenant before God.
Son un pacto ante Dios.
And this is the strongest covenant that can happen between two human beings.
Y este es el pacto más fuerte que puede haber entre dos seres humanos.
Which God seals and makes unbreakable.
Que Dios sella y los hace irrompibles.
Remember, the marriage is a compromise that involves God.
Recuerden que el matrimonio es un compromiso que envuelve a Dios.
Where you promise to take care of each other.
donde prometen cuidarse el uno al otro,
love each other,
amarse el uno al otro,
in all situation,
en toda situación,
and to face life together,
para encarar la vida juntos,
and to do it until one of you dies,
y para hacerlo hasta que uno de los dos muera,
or Jesus comes,
o Dios o Jesús vuelva,
whatever happens first,
lo que sea que pase primero.
Now the purpose of marriage is,
ahora el propósito del matrimonio es,
to keep each other company,
para mantener compañía uno del otro,
help each other,
ayudarse,
multiply,
multiplicarse,
and to enjoy each other,
y quererse uno al otro,
disfrutarse uno al otro, emotionally, physically, and spiritually.
Emocionalmente, físicamente y espiritualmente.
So it is very important that you have fun during your marriage.
So es muy importante que encuentren diversión en su matrimonio.
Never forget,
nunca olviden,
that a beautiful marriage,
que un bello matrimonio,
is beautiful,
es bello,
because it is built beautifully,
porque es construido bellamente,
and that God has given you everything that you need,
y Dios les ha dado todo lo que necesitan,
even His presence,
incluso su presencia,
His guidance,
su guía,
His instructions,
sus instrucciones,
His power,
su poder,
His authority,
su autoridad,
but you must build it,
pero ustedes deben construirlo,
and you will get as a result,
y van a tener como resultado,
what you decide to build,
lo que decían construir.
So every time that you're starting something,
cada vez que empiecen algo,
it is really nice to think what that thing is going to be with the time.
Tienen que pensar bien en lo que va a hacer con el tiempo.
Let's say that you are starting a new business.
Por ejemplo, que empiece un nuevo negocio.
You like to daydream about what this business is going to become.
Y hablen sobre qué negocio se va a convertir.
And you hope that it becomes a really good business, yeah?
Y esperan que se vuelva un buen negocio, ¿verdad?
And of course, you are starting a new family.
Y por supuesto, están empezando una nueva familia.
So, it is good to daydream. What is going to be this family like?
Es bueno soñar en cómo va a ser esta familia en el futuro.
Is it going to be a great family?
¿Va a ser una gran familia?
Is it going to be a beautiful family?
¿Va a ser una hermosa familia?
Is it going to be a happy family?
¿Va a ser una familia feliz?
Well, the answer is really simple.
La respuesta es muy sencilla.
This family is what you decide that this family is going to be.
Es lo que ustedes decían que vaya a ser.
Because you are the ones who are going to be building it.
Porque ustedes son los que van a estar construyendo.
And God has given you everything.
Y Dios les ha dado todo.
To make it a great, beautiful, and happy family.
Para hacer una gran, hermosa y feliz familia.
But nobody is going to do it for you.
Pero nadie lo va a hacer por ustedes.
You are going to have to do it with God.
Van a tener que hacerlo con Dios.
So, make the best out of this beautiful family. And of course, you are going to be living in a beautiful home.
Saquen lo mejor de esta familia y por supuesto van a construir un hermoso hogar.
But like everything that is being built,
pero como todo que cuando se construye,
it is very important that you understand your own responsibilities.
Es muy importante que entiendan sus responsabilidades.
Because God, you're laughing because you know what I'm going to be asking, yeah?
El riesgo que sabes que va a preguntar, ¿verdad?
Okay, because God has decided what is going to be your role and your responsibility.
Porque Dios ha decidido cuál va a ser tu voto y tu responsabilidad.
And of course yours.
Y por supuesto el tuyo.
And sometimes in marriage it is difficult because neither the groom or the bride, they don't know what they have to do.
Y a veces el matrimonio es difícil porque ni el novio ni la novia saben qué van a hacer.
So we see the husband doing what the wife is supposed to be doing.
So vemos al esposo haciendo lo que la esposa debería hacer.
The wife doing what God is supposed to be doing.
La esposa haciendo lo que Dios debería hacer.
And God asking, can I do something?
Y Dios preguntando, ¿puedo hacer algo?
So that is not going to happen with you.
Entonces eso no va a pasar con ustedes.
Because you better know your own responsibilities.
Porque es mejor que es bueno que sepan sus propias responsabilidades.
Because you know that I'm about to do a test.
Porque saben que voy a hacer una prueba.
And if you don't answer right,
y si no contestan correctamente,
I'm going to ask it to pack my food,
voy a pedirles que paquen mi comida,
my coffee,
mi café,
and I'm leaving without performing any ceremony, okay?
Sin hacer la ceremonia.
The dog agrees with me, okay? So Sergio, tell us all of us, what are your responsibilities in marriage?
Sergio, ¿cuáles son tus responsabilidades en el matrimonio?
My responsibilities in marriage are to be a spiritual leader.
Mis responsabilidades son ser un líder espiritual.
A household leader.
Un proveedor de la familia.
and emotional nurturer, a provider, a protector,
protector,
and a father,
grower,
and developer.
Oh, you know them. Your brother does not, but you know them. So I'm going to explain all of them. When it says that you're a spiritual leader, what it means is that with your example, you have to lead your family into the fear of the Lord. That because if you pray, your family are going to pray.
Tu familia ora.
Because you go to church every Sunday.
Porque si tú vas a la familia a la iglesia cada domingo.
Your family are going to follow you.
Tu familia te va a seguir.
They're going to do what they see you doing.
Ellos van a hacer lo que te van haciendo.
So be an example.
So, sé un ejemplo.
About being a home leader.
Sobre ser un líder del hogar.
You have to understand that there is a purpose for this family.
Tienes que entender que hay un propósito para esta familia.
And that purpose was defined by God.
Y ese propósito lo es definido por Dios.
And you have to lead your family.
Y tienes que liderar a tu familia.
To fulfill that purpose.
Para completar ese propósito.
Now, the third one.
El tercero.
That is fulfill your wife emotionally.
Que es llenar a tu esposa emocionalmente.
Is a very important one.
Es muy importante.
Because maybe you don't know yet.
Porque quizás no lo sepas todavía.
But women.
Pero las mujeres.
Today they are happy.
Pero que son, hoy son felices.
Tomorrow they are sad.
Mañana están tristes.
And they don't know why.
Y no saben por qué.
But sometimes they're going to blame you.
Pero a veces te van a culpar.
You know that a sailor, un marinero, he doesn't call sea.
No llama mar.
You know, in a male way. But in una manera masculina. But it calls it in Spanish. La mar, saying that it's female, because today is calm, but tomorrow it can be a hurricane. So you have to understand that God has given you one ability, and it's to take that hurricane and make it calm. How? You're going to fulfill her. Emotionally. So when she's having those kind of changes mood,
cuando tenga esos cambios emocionales,
you are not going to run away.
No vas a salir corriendo.
Even though it's what you are going to want to do.
A pesar de que sea lo que quieras hacer.
You are going to go.
Vas a ir.
You are going to love her.
Vas a amarla.
She's going to feel love.
Vas a sentir amor.
And she's going to be calm.
Y ella se va a calmar.
Okay? And just know that all your brothers,
entiende que todos tus hermanos,
around the world,
en todo el mundo,
are living the same.
Están
about being a provider.
Sobre ser un proveedor.
Maybe you two are going to be working. But you are responsible before God.
Pero tú eres responsable ante Dios.
To be the provider.
De ser el proveedor.
About being the protector.
Sobre ser el protector.
God made you.
Dios te hizo.
Stronger.
Más fuerte.
Not only physically.
No solamente físicamente,
but emotionally,
sino emocionalmente,
and physically, and spiritually.
Y espiritualmente.
Because you have to protect your family.
Porque tienes que proteger tu familia.
And a way to protect them,
y una manera de protegerlos,
is to always,
es siempre,
honor God.
Honrar a Dios.
And to have a great attitude,
y tener una buena actitud,
before everything,
antes de que todo,
what you may face in life.
Lo que encares en la vida.
About being a progenitor, developer, and grower.
Sobre ser progenitor, desarrollador y
it means that everything that you do,
significa que todo lo que hagas,
is going to impact not only you,
no solo te va a impactar a ti,
but your children,
sino tus
and
hijos,
children of your children.
Los hijos de tus hijos.
So always obey and honor God.
So siempre obedece y honra a Dios.
And make sure that your future generations.
Y asegúrate de que las futuras generaciones
receive a blessing
reciban una bendición
from you.
De ti.
Okay, now Crystal, we're going to the woman part. What are your responsibilities?
Okay, Crystal, vamos por la parte de la novia. ¿Cuáles son tus responsabilidades?
To be his ideal help.
Ser su ayuda idónea. someterme.
Respect him.
Respetarlo.
And reproduce kids. Yeah.
Amar es muy importante para hacer. No me voy a casar hasta que me digas la última. Lo más importante para un hombre. Le puedes ayudar.
Okay, you don't have to do this one. Okay, don't worry. I don't think that he will mind. Okay, the fit, I'm gonna tell you. Then, and after that, I'm gonna speak to your mentors. Okay, don't worry. Who was your mentor? This one is really important for Cheo, so I do have to speak to him, okay? Okay. So, the woman, one of your responsibilities is to be his helpmate, and that means actually to support him. You have to understand that he is the leader that God has given for this family, and he needs your support.
Una de tus responsabilidades es ser su ayuda, que él necesita que tú seas su apoyo.
The second one is to submit to your husband.
La segunda es someterte a tu esposo.
And it's important to understand.
Es importante entender
that it's not about doing his will.
Que no es sobre que hagas solo todo lo que él diga.
But letting him,
sino dejarlo,
guide you,
guiarte,
in God's will,
en la voluntad de Dios.
And that is exactly why God gave him authority.
Y eso es exactamente porque Dios le dio autoridad a él.
To be able to guide you.
Para guiarte.
And to protect you.
Y protegerte.
To respect him.
Para respetarlo.
Sometimes people think.
A veces la gente piensa.
That you have to gain respect.
Que tú tienes que ganarte respeto.
But actually respect is something that God has already given to your husband.
Pero de hecho es algo que Dios, el respeto es algo que Dios ya le dio a tu esposo.
When you respect him.
Cuando lo respetas.
You are giving him.
Le estás dando.
What belongs to him.
Lo que le pertenece.
A man who feels respected by his wife.
Un hombre que se siente respetado por su esposa.
Is a man that is going to love his wife.
Es un hombre que va a amar a su esposa.
So I will respect him.
Entonces respétalo.
And take advantage of those moments publicly.
Y toma ventaja de estos momentos públicamente.
To honor him and respect him.
Para honrarlo y respetarlo.
To reproduce life.
Para reproducir vida.
I hope you have many kids.
Espero que tengan muchos niños.
And for that it's important.
Y para eso es importante.
That you comply with the fifth one.
Que cumplas con la quinta.
To meet him sexually.
Para hacerlo sexualmente.
And sometimes.
Y a veces.
It is common that men.
Los hombres.
Es más común que los hombres. Okay. They want to have more sex than women.